project is entitled as Composite Structural Analysis on an Aeroshell of Reentry Vehicle. So a reentry vehicle is nothing but a space vehicle or spacecraft that is entering into our atmosphere after completing its function in the outer space. So these vehicles have already been launched into outer space via rocket or some satellite launching vehicle. So all these type of reentry vehicles will be in the shape of spherical cone as shown in the picture here. The only major difference between all these different type of reentry vehicles will be the dimensions and the diameter of the sphere and basically the core structure of these type of vehicles. But anyways, the shape of this vehicle will be almost similar in all cases in all types of reentry vehicles. One of the main thing to consider here is the type of material used here. So for such purposes, some high strength metals and composite materials will be used in order to function in high efficiency in these type of reentry vehicles. So these composites used in this reentry vehicles will be metal matrix composites as well as ceramic matrix composites. And also they will be using some high strength metals like titanium alloys and all. So our project will also be based on this particular perspective. So here what we will be doing is that we will be analyzing a typical structure of reentry vehicle, that is a spherical cone structure of like a reentry vehicle, in which our focus will be on the structural part of the vehicle. We will be using the material property as different types of composites and some alloys to compare its efficiency in different cases. So our main focus will be to find the a better functioning composite combinations for this type of boundary conditions and for this type of reentry purposes. So generally, this reentry capsule, it will be entering its atmosphere with a very high Mach number, that is at hypersonic speed. So it will be like around 15 to 25 Mach number and all. And almost at the altitude of 10 kilometers from the sea level, where the density of the air is very high, and when there is the ideal gas is present, it will be entering the atmosphere with a really high velocity. So it will actually affect the structure of the entire aeroshell of the reentry vehicle, and it will also lead to some deformation and certain failure in the structural systems. So what we'll be doing is that by assigning different composite combinations to such structure and such shapes and all, we will be able to find a suitable composite material or a suitable alloy material which could withstand such intense boundary conditions and such heavy stress forming factors and all. So our ultimate aim will be to optimize this particular reentry vehicle composite structure in order to withstand all these reentry conditions which might lead to some major stress deformations and all. So different iterations will be taken place in this particular project to investigate different combinations of composites and different combinations of alloys and all. Also we can try it out with the different shapes of reentry vehicle, that is different dimensions with the same spherical cone structures, by modifying the height of the capsule or the radius of the sphere and all such. So at the end of the project, we'll be able to land an ideal structural composition for the typical reentry vehicle, which could be very helpful for research in this particular area.
What she is explaining is about the composite structure of the reentry vehicle. The stress that withstands during the re-entry vehicle enters the earth when the satellite has been launched. The re-entry vehicle enters the earth with high velocity, so the stress withstand by the re-entry vehicle is very high. So for that reason, they are doing the research on composite materials used in the re-entry vehicle. Also they focus on the size and shape of the re-entry vehicle, and for to change their dimensions and the material used. So that is she is explaining in this video. Thank you.